The previous video ended with me telling you to go chase those green bullets. And the bullets are a key part of the Yoast SEO plugin. The Yoast SEO bullets serve to give you intuitive feedback on your text and gamify the Yoast SEO experience. Trying to get all green bullets can become an addiction, but it isn't necessarily the best way of creating great copy. Over the years, we've seen all kinds of misconceptions about the green bullets on social media and in our support channels. So let's discuss some of them to get a feel for how to approach the bullets' feedback. Misconception number one, I have some red and orange bullets, so I will never rank. Okay, generally, the more green bullets, the more SEO fit your text is, as I told you in the previous video. But not every bullet has to be green. The bullets indicate strengths and weaknesses in your text, and they can help you easily identify some of the elements you can improve on. But don't take them as gospel. They are tools and not commandments. Also, and this is most important, never try to cheat the game by tinkering with your text until your red and orange bullets turn green. Use the plugin feedback to your advantage, and use common sense to determine whether you can make improvements to your text. Therefore, we always advise you to write the text first, and only check the feedback once you feel that the text is finished. Misconception number two, all my bullets are green, but I still don't rank. It goes the other way around as well. If all your bullets are green, that doesn't mean you'll rank. First of all, green bullets don't equal a great text necessarily. If your text has great readability but doesn't have good information, you won't be the best result. Moreover, if you base your text too much on the bullets' feedback, your text may actually even be worse than it may have been otherwise. Don't become a slave of the green bullets. Of course, it's also perfectly possible that you've written a great text, but your competition is very stiff, and all of them have also written great texts. Or you may have SEO issues in other areas. Misconception number three, every post should be optimized. They don't. Not all posts have to be optimized. You have to consider whether your posts will be part of your SEO strategy. Some posts will suffer if you optimize them because you focus too much on trying to rank. Others, like announcements, don't make sense to optimize for anyway. Consider whether your post fits your SEO strategy and make a conscious decision on whether you want to optimize it. Misconception number four. If I paste Hemingway into the readability analysis, all I see is red and orange, so you can't really trust the Yoast SEO feedback. This is important. The Yoast SEO readability analysis is aimed at optimizing for online content. Hemingway wasn't looking to sell pens or maintain a mommy blog or whatever. Most online authors are not trying to write the great American novel, and they shouldn't. They should write readable online content. That's the goal, so that's what the plugin measures. Misconception number five, Yoast SEO hates my writing style. We don't hate your writing style. Actually, who knows, we may hate your writing style. In any case, the Yoast SEO plugin doesn't. It merely provides you with readability feedback. Your writing style may not fit the guidelines for good SEO copy. Research has shown, for example, that overusing passive voice leads to worse readability. Research has also shown that using too many long sentences makes your text difficult to read. This is especially important when it comes to online copy. We don't think that's a question of style. You can decide for yourself whether you agree. And if you don't, ignore the feedback at your own risk. Misconception number six. Yoast SEO wants me to dumb down my text. No. We want your text to be as clear as possible. And you should aim to write as clearly as possible. Most of you are trying to reach a broad audience, and many of you are trying to reach non-native speakers as well. Using simple vocab and short sentences does not equal dumbing down your text. It's the other way around. It opens your copy up to a broader audience. This is especially important when it comes to online copy. Because the longer it takes for your audience to grasp what you're trying to say, the bigger the chances are of them bouncing off your site. Attention spans are short online, so cater to them. And of course, sometimes you have to use jargon in a technical text, but generally you should aim to keep things simple. Writing clearly and concisely is an art, not a shortcoming.